Hey, so are you familiar with the New York Times game called Connections?
Yes, in the New York Times game Connections, players try to group words or phrases into categories based on their shared characteristics or themes. It's a fun puzzle that challenges your ability to find connections among seemingly unrelated words. Have you tried it?
Yeah, so just as an experiment, I thought it'd be fun for you to be my sort of sidekick here. And I'll read out the words to you and we can kind of brainstorm together. So the words are bull, rush, kick, stand, bear, tongue, tripe, stomach, high, heels, thrill, mouse, baloney, remote, take, and bunk. Do you see any patterns?
Let's see. A few categories jump out right away. Some of these words relate to body parts like stomach, heels, tongue, and tripe. Then there are words associated with actions or movements like kick, rush, take, and stand. Some could be types of meat or food items like tongue, tripe, bologna, and stomach. What do you think? Any other connections popping out to you?
Yeah, I think I was seeing a pattern. Let me see if I can find it again. So, what
Sure.
about, sorry, still just thinking here. What about stomach and bear and take? What do you see the pattern that I'm getting at there?
It sounds like you're hinting at phrases that involve those words. Stomach, as in stomach the idea, bear, as in bear with me, and take, as in take part. So maybe these are all words that are used in common expressions.
Yeah, well, I mean, I'm thinking of synonyms. So like to be able to stomach something, to be able to bear something, to be able to take it.
Got it. So, words that are synonyms for enduring or tolerating something.
Yeah, exactly.
Stomach.
So, can you think of a fourth word that I've listed that might be a fourth to go with that?
A fourth word from your list that fits with stomach, bear, and take as synonyms for enduring or tolerating. Maybe stand?
Yeah.
Like, to stand something means to tolerate it.
Yeah, let me try
Does
that.
that.
Yeah, stand, bear, stomach, take. I'm gonna submit that and see if that's it. Yeah, we got it.
Fantastic. Nicely spotted with the synonyms. It's always satisfying when a hunch pays off. If you want to try another round or brainstorm some more categories, just let me know.
All right, so let's see if there are, can you, yeah, can you find any other groups of four synonyms?
Sure. Let's take another look at your list. Thrill, rush, kick, and high could all be related to excitement or a burst of adrenaline. For another set, heels, tongue, tripe, and stomach as body parts. Do these groupings make sense, or do you see any others that might work?
I really like that first one. So you said rush, high, kick, and thrill. Let me
Thrill.
try that.
All right, let's see if this set captures the adrenaline-charged vibes we were going for.
Yeah,
Give it a try.
that was right. Yep, the second one or that set of four worked. So, let me see here. What does tripe mean?
Sorry, I didn't quite catch what you said. Could you say that again?
Yeah, I'm just wondering, what does the word tripe mean? I'm not familiar with that word.
Tripe is the edible lining from the stomachs of various farm animals, most commonly cows. It's considered a delicacy in some cuisines, often used in dishes like soups or stews. So it fits that body parts category we were talking about earlier, too.
Okay, but we've already used stomach in the first set of four, so I think it was probably like a what do you call it? Like a red herring. So I don't think it's actually referring to stomach. Does it have another meaning?
You're right. It might be a red herring in the body parts sense. Another meaning of tripe is something that's nonsense or trivial. So it could fit with the idea of something that's not worth much or is insubstantial. Does that help or? should we explore other angles for the remaining set of synonyms?
Okay, so yeah, I wasn't familiar with that definition for it. Are there any words that would fit with that second meaning of tripe that would be synonymous with that?
With that meaning of tripe, we're looking for synonyms that also can convey the idea of something trivial or nonsensical. From your list, maybe baloney fits that bill, as it's often used to describe nonsense or foolishness. What do you think?
Yeah, that sounds great. Let's go with that. So we've got tripe and baloney. Can we find two other ones that go with that?
Let's see. Along the same lines of tripe and baloney, how about bunk and baloney? Bunk can also mean nonsense or foolish talk. And for the fourth one, baloney works too. This set covers a lot of linguistic ground, though. Shall we go with those?
Okay, it sounds good, but it sounds like you're getting a little bit confused. You referred to baloney a number of times. So we've got baloney, tripe, and bunk. That sounds great. Is there a fourth word that we can add to that?
Oops, my mistake there. For a fourth word that fits with baloney, tripe, and bunk, how about baloney is another word for nonsense. So it fits that category nicely.
You keep referring to baloney as a word that can be added, but it's already part of the three words that we've selected. So we got baloney, tripe, and bunk, and we're looking for a fourth word that isn't baloney, tripe, or bunk to add to our list.
Got it. My mistake. Looking through the list with this in mind, mouse might work, as in a timid person, someone who doesn't have a lot of substance, or maybe remote, like something far-fetched or disconnected from reality. Either of those seem like they might fit?
I don't like mouse. Remote is kind of an interesting possibility, but what about bull?
Yes, bull could work well here. Bull is used as a slang term for nonsense or falsehoods, which aligns with the triviality theme we've got going with tripe, baloney, and bunk. Let's go with that.
All right, giving it a try. Yeah, that's right.
Awesome. Nicely done picking out those connections. If you're up for another challenge or just want to chat about something else, let me know.
Well, don't give up on me yet because we still have the final category, although I guess it's obvious that they need to go together. But I'm curious just for fun if you can figure out what the pattern is, because I'm definitely not seeing it. So the four words are heels, remote, tongue, and mouse. What's the connection?
All right, let's think this through. Heels, remote, tongue, and mouse could all be things that you click. You can click your heels, a remote, your tongue, and a computer mouse. Seem like it fits.
That's genius. I never would have thought of that, but that sounds right. Let me try it.
Okay. Give it a shot.
And it turns out you are right. So really impressive. Thanks for the help.
You're welcome. It's been a lot of fun figuring these out with you. If you ever want to tackle another puzzle or just chat, feel free to reach out.